Hello all, today I'm going to give you a demo of Tributary3d's free tributary area calculator, which can be used to calculate column loads. So you can access it through tributary3d.com/free-column-tributary-area-calculator. And it's a tool that's been around for quite some time, and it's used by many engineers on a daily basis. So it's safe to say that it's a robust and reliable tool at this stage. So the way that it works is that you have this viewport in the middle, and similar to many other CAD software, you use the scroll wheel on your mouse to zoom in and zoom out. And then you use the right button to pan around like this, and then the left button to make selections. And the first thing that I wanted to show you is the settings menu here. And you click on this little cog down at the left side, and then you have a few different options here. For instance, like some display settings for the grid lines, and then you have some object visibility settings, snap settings, and then finally unit settings. So here you can toggle over to imperial system. So I'm gonna do that for this demo to use feet instead of meters. So I click on apply, and the anatomy of the tool here is that you have the toolbar to the left side like this, and as mentioned, the viewport in the middle, and then you have the panels to the right. And the panel then consists of a few different tabs, which we'll talk more about later. So the toolbar consists of different buttons, and clicking on one of these buttons basically launches a command or a tool. So I'm going to start out with drawing a floor. So I click on the floor button, and as you can see here on the right side, we get a few different options. Either I can enter the coordinates for my floor numerically, or I can also use the viewport to actually draw the floor. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. So I start here, and let's draw it to 20 feet, and then I go up here to 25, 45, 20, 25, and then back to where I started. So by clicking on the same vertex that I started with, it's going to recognize that it's a closed polygon, and that will go ahead and create the floor for me. So the next thing that I want to do is to define an opening in this floor. So that could be, for instance, an elevator shaft or something like that. So I click on the floor, I go to the toolbar, click on the add opening button. And now in the similar fashion that I drew my floor, I will be able to draw my my opening. So let's do something like that. Okay, next thing, I want to activate the draw column tool. So I click here, I draw the location for my columns. So each one of those little points will basically represent a column in this configuration. And perhaps I want to add a few more here at the middle, something like that. Great. So the answer, so the question that this program can answer is how much of the floor loading goes into each one of those individual columns. And to be able to answer that question, I can run the compute tribs button here. So I run that, and as you can see, the program generates tributary areas for the columns. And that essentially means that for every individual material point here, which column is the closest. So there are plenty of material on tributary3d.com, the blog, which you can read more about how this algorithm actually works. It uses a method called Voronoi to do that. And when I have this calculated in the viewport here now, I can go over to the labels tab and click on the tribs. Yeah, right. So here you can see the different tributary areas defined for the individual columns. So we can easily see that this is the most loaded column. This is the least loaded column. Sorry, this is the least loaded column. Okay, I can also unlock the model if I actually want to go ahead and rearrange something in my model. So let's say that I select these columns. I activate the move tool. Move those upwards like that. Perhaps I want to get rid of that column and maybe define another one down here. So I do that, and then essentially hit the compute tribs button again, and that will recalculate the tributary areas, which I can then use the trib checkbox here to actually see the tributary areas. I can also click on the individual columns like this to go to the properties tab, and that will actually show me well, first of all, the coordinates for this individual column, but then also the total tributary area. So that's pretty much everything that I wanted to show you in this demo. There is a paid version of this tool as well, which will give you access to a few more nice features, such as the draw wall tool, which will allow you to not only draw columns, but then also define walls that can attract load like this. And then you can also use the draw area load tool. So for instance, here in the tool, we calculated the tributary areas. So to be able to calculate the actual column load, you would have to multiply that with the pressure that is applied on the floor. So let's say that you had a load or a pressure on the floor that's 10 PSF or pounds per square foot, then you would essentially multiply that number with the tributary area. And then you can also import the XF files if you have the paid version, and then you can download Excel files and the XF files, and you can also save your configurations if you have an account. So yeah, feel free to use the tool as much as you want. Feel free to make any recommendations of extra features you would like to see in the tool. Feel free to upgrade it at any time if you want to try out the paid version of the tool. There is a free trial for 2 weeks, and feel free to subscribe to the YouTube channel if you're interested in more free tools, engineering content, and updates from Tributary3d. I'll also post a link to the free tool in the description of this video. So that's everything for me. Thank you. Till next time.